Okay, we're gonna do a little change out. Gas furnace and straight AC. I think it's 3.5 tons. So we're here to take a quick look at it. Be sure to get the exact right unit. All right, let's go up here and take a look. Upflow. All right, comfort taker. So, plenty of room. The pan looks okay. It's one of those welded pans. Not crazy about that. But it is nice and deep. The main thing about these upflows is we gotta make sure we got plenty of headroom in case our coil is taller, and see how close that is. So we may have to just slide over to the left a little bit, and that gives us what we're gonna need, because I'm gonna imagine we got another couple of inches of coil. And this is a rigid trunk line. Fit right there. I think these are nothing but just temporary wind braces. They don't look really important, although that one is holding the light and some wires. There goes a gas line. Not the greatest flex job, but the trunk line looks pretty nice. May let my guys come in here and look for the first joint. Probably right along in here, and pull that open so that we can raise that up a little bit. But should be able to hook right out. Now, one thing I'm glad of is I used an increaser here instead of running 3 inch all the way out the roof. There's a lot of room behind it. So this should be okay. This should be an easy change out. Let's go take a look at the outside unit. All right, so that's a pretty nice looking attic situation. And the old round comfort taker. So this thing looks like the whip is plenty long enough if it's not brittle. It's a 1999, 3.5 tons. I'd say they got their money's worth out of it. Looks like that water heater pop-off valve is a constant dripper. I don't see anything out of ours, so obviously the AC is not operable at the moment. So we're gonna change that. I'm gonna go get them the proper equipment and get this thing done. Let's get to work. Okay, we're almost done. Should be having it running shortly. All right, we got it changed out. And we did take a piece of 16-inch flex and tie back into the trunk line, which let us get below that piece of wood right there. Because as we looked at yesterday, our plenum was definitely going to go up a few inches more. Looks like we got about a 4-inch taller coil. Other than that, it all went back exactly like it was. We're happy with it. Sounds like it's cycling back on. It's been running about an hour. But I just heard the outside unit come on. So This blower should ramp up. It is variable speed. Now, as you can see, it's actually communicating the XC80 instead of the XV80, which Train had to give it to me because it didn't have the one I wanted in stock. So we're guaranteed a certain amount of things, not a whole lot, but anyway, when we have to upgrade to get a job done, they'll credit us the difference. So we got the communicating furnace and just went on the CDA and programmed it for 24 volt operation. So this is a single stage 16 SEER system. And let's take a look at the control in the outside unit. This customer should be happy. Okay, so we got our 16 SEER single stage XL16i. I'll tell you, they come out of the crate. Styrofoam and dirt all over them. Right out of the crate there. So, as we can see, much different from yesterday's 20 SEER. It's a little bitty filter dryer with that one today. So now we got twins out here dripping. We got the water heater one that's still dripping. And this one has already cycled a couple of times. It's been running about an hour. So we can see that we're making water. So I'm pretty happy with it. There's a fly there trying to get in. And I sure like that. So, and then Train puts this, because if you only buy the unit and don't match it up properly, that's all you're going to get. So that's its minimum. But we're getting the full 16 because we do have the proper coil and the variable speed blower in the furnace. Go get a installers are rough. Clean this up a bit. It's a tad. So let's take a look at the control. Make sure everything's set on it the way we like it. Not too bad. That mud came off of there. That's using for a table if you let them. So there's the unit. Let's take a look at the controls and we get out of these people's way. Okay, so we got the 824 here. Gave the customer the book. Of course, he can get it online and get his weather app and his Nexia active and work it from his cell phone or any computer in the world. And we do have scheduling disabled at the moment. So we always give them the book and let them do some personal preferences from there. We've been running it quite a bit, so, you know, for setup and everything, so we got the house kind of cool at the moment. Totally cool, you know. We see a lot of things in a lot of people's houses. Crazy dogs, crazy kids, hobbies, cars, bikes, motorcycles. Saw a lady the other day with an indoor gym and a couple of monkeys on it, in it. Actual reality. However, this one, I haven't seen this yet. He strings his own tennis rackets. I would have never known what that thing was for if it didn't have that tennis racket sitting on it. Just thought I'd look at it. So, say goodbye to the old comfort taker. I'm gonna take our flush box and stuff and leave this. The scrap crew will be by here shortly to pick up these discarded items. And there's another one done. Let's go over and check on the other job. All right, that was a really nice young fella there. And I never had seen one of those apparatuses that restrings tennis rackets. And we see a lot in this business, but you know, that was actually a first there. So I just thought I'd grab a quick shot of it. So anyway, we're headed to go check on the other job, which should be getting close to being done. Got to run on a couple of service calls myself today. Not sure if I'll get footage or not. You never know when you got a helicopter or customer or when they just leave you alone. And we don't usually film in front of them. So I'm sure you can understand how that is. So I appreciate you watching, and we're on our way to the next one. We'll wait.